Welcome to our new Oriental School. New concept in class, book 3. Please open your textbooks at page 14. Let's begin to learn lesson 1, a pupil at large. If you want to study the text well, we must be familiar with the words, of course. So read with me aloud. Pupil. Support. Evidence.Accumulate, oblige, hunt, blackberry, human being, corner, trill, print, clean, clung, convince, somehow, disturb. It is unnecessary for us.To know the vocabulary, of course, I should say, to know the expression of the vocabulary, we must learn how to use them. So, when we learn a word, we must put it in a sentence. And when we study a key structure, we must put it in a little passage. 那我们同学们在学习词汇的时候，如果仅知道汉语的语义，是远远不足的。所以学习词汇的时候要把它放在一个完整的语句当中，来充分的体会如何去应用这个词。那么在学习一个关键句型结构的时候，至少能够放在一篇小小的段落里，或者是一篇文章里。 OK, it's our time to study how to use the words one by one, particularly the important words. So first, support.Support is a transitive word. It means pick out, see, recognize, catch sight of. 同学们发现我用几个同义的词汇和短语解释了 support. 它本身是一个及物动词，发现、看见、认出。For example,A tall man is easy to spot in a crowd. A tall man is easy to spot in a crowd. 高个子人在人群中是很容易认出的。He has a good eye for spotting mistakes. He has a good eye for spotting mistakes. 他有敏锐的识别错误的眼睛。啊，或者我们把它理解为他识别错误的洞察力很强。我们在学习 spot 这个动词的时候，要注意辨析其同义词。spot 相当于 see, 强调结果，辨别出，看见，识别，发现。而 find, 发现，它侧重强调发现了的结果。find out,查出事实真相。那么如果我们表示做出重大发现的时候呢，经常用到 discover。 Discover, I especially make a discovery. 那么我们如果强调注意到 notice, 观察 observe。 但如果表示观看活动中的人物或者是画面，大家知道应该使用的词汇 watchSo, please read after me the following words aloud, spot, see, find, find out, discover, notice, observe, catch sight of. You should make sure how to use them. 我们刚刚提到了 spot, 及物动词的用法，它还是一个名词。表示斑点。For example, there is a white spot on the shirt. 在这件衬衫上有一白色的斑点。重点突出的表达方式 on the spot. 英文中的介词短语浮现率是相当高的，所以有的人呢甚至把英文称之为是介词的语言。Do you know how to use on the spot? It has got two meanings. 那么如何运用介词短语 on the spot? 这个短语有两个含义。这是一个非常不正式的表达方式。首先它表示立刻马上。It means at once. Immediately. For example, anyone breaking the rules will be asked to leave on the spot.Anyone breaking the rules will be asked to leave on the spot. 任何一个违反条例的人马上被请求离开。Secondly, it means at the place of the action. 那么第二点呢，它的含义在现场。Wherever she's needed, she's quickly on the spot.Wherever she's needed, she's quickly on the spot. 无论哪里需要她，她迅速会赶到现场。Okay, now, let's get on to study evidence. Evidence, 证据。This is an uncountable noun, 这是一个不可数名词。Now, translate my sentence into Chinese.When the police arrived, he had already destroyed the evidence. When the police arrived, he had already destroyed the evidence. 当警察来到的时候，他早已经把这证据销毁掉了。The evidence means proof. P-R-O-O-F. We have got a very good word, you know, phrase, preposition phrase, huh?我们有一个很好的介词短语 in evidence. In evidence, 显而易见的。He was in evidence at the party. He was in evidence at the party. 他这个人在晚会上就很突出。我们在应用的时候要注意到 evidence 的副词形式 evidently, 形容词 evident.E-V-I-D-E-N-T. Okay, read after me. Evidence. In evidence. Evident. Evidently. Accumulate. 积累积聚 This is a transitive verb and intransitive verb. 这是一个及物动词也是一个不及物动词 Means make or become greater in quantity or size.它主要是侧重强调积累的过程。那 listen to me, and of course, we should practice our listening when we study English in our class. Do you concentrate your mind on me? As the evidence accumulates, experts from the zoo felt obliged to investigate.随着证据的积累，动物园的专家们觉得有必要要进行调查了。那我们在应用的时候，新根尼二册当中曾经出现过几个词汇 ：gather、collect、assemble。那么应该如何去应用这些同义词呢 ？gather， 及物动词，聚集，也表示把某人召集在某处。We gathered under town hall clock. 我们聚集在钟楼下。The teacher gathered his students in the class. 老师把学生们召集在教室里面。而 collect, 收集、采集。Do you collect stamps? 你集邮吗 ？Yeah, I collect stamps as my hobby. 是的，我集邮作为一种我的爱好。而 assemble,集合、集会，也是一个及物动词，表示装配。A large number of people assemble on the square. 大量的人在这个广场上集合。那么同时呢，我们还要求同学把握住如何运用 hard, H-O-A-R-D.这个及物动词侧重点在于大量的贮存。 Now listen to me and translate my sentence into Chinese. You know how to use the word hot. The squirrel holds up nuts for the cold winter. The squirrel holds up nuts for the cold winter. 松鼠为了炎冷的冬天，寒冷的冬天呢，储存了大量的坚果。Hot 经常和 up 搭配连用，那么它相当于同一段语 store up, store。最后一点，我们要提及到 amass, amass。那么这词本身也表示积聚，主要是用于诗歌或文学作品当中 ，means come together， 表示聚集在一起 ，come together。For instance, the clouds amassed above the hills. The clouds amassed above the hills. 云在山顶上空聚集。Okay, now next important word, oblige. This is a transitive verb. It means make somebody feel it is necessary to do something. Make somebody feel it is necessary to do something.In Chinese, 使感到必须。我们在运用这个动词的时候，主要是用于过去分词形式 obliged. Feel obliged to do something, 这是大家要掌握的第一个短语。感觉有必要去做某事。I feel obliged to say no to his demand. I feel obliged to say no to his demand. 我感觉有必要。要对他的要求说不，要拒绝他的要求。第二点，我们主要用一段语 be obliged to do something， be obliged to do something， 被迫做某事。They were obliged to sell their car to pay their debts off. They were obliged to sell their car to pay their debts off. 他们被迫把车卖掉来偿还债务。Got it? Remember? Feel obliged to do and be obliged to do. Next, hunt. Hunt is a verb and noun. Hunt 既是动词追猎，也是名词追猎寻找。